Hey guys, welcome back to Tech Wrapped. Last week, OxygenOS open beta ROMs based on Android Pi were released for OnePlus 5 and 5T, and many users who flashed the ROM were reporting that they are having issues with Google Pay, Bluetooth, GPS and mic. The thing is that I never faced any of these issues except the safety net fail thing, which you can fix by clearing the storage data of Google Pay services and Google Pay store. In order to do this, go to Settings tab, Apps and Notifications, See All Apps, and here search for Google Play Services, and under Storage tab, hit Clear Storage. Next, do the same thing for Google Play Store too, and once done, reboot your phone, and then update the Google Play Store app to the latest version. This should fix the safety net problem, and if it didn't work for you, then you can factory reset your phone by going to Settings, System, Reset Options and select Erase All Data. So by default, your apps and app data will be erased. Optionally, you can also wipe the entire internal storage including pictures, videos and other files. If you don't want any data loss, there is one unconventional way to fix it, and for this you need to download the latest HydrogenOS and OxygenOS Pi open beta ROMs for OnePlus 5 or 5T. So once you have downloaded these two ROMs, place them in the internal storage of your phone. If you had downloaded these two files from the phone itself, then transfer these two zip files from the download or downloads folder to the root folder, and then only you will be able to see these files in the next step. Now go to Settings, System, System Updates, gear icon at the top right corner, Local Upgrade, and now select the HydrogenOS Pi open beta ROM and hit Upgrade Now. So now H2OS ROM will be flashed to your phone, and rest assured all your data is safe. Once the H2OS ROM has been flashed, go to Settings again, System, System Updates, gear icon, Local Upgrade, and now select the OxygenOS Pi open beta ROM and hit Upgrade Now. So after reboot, everything should be fine, safety net will be fixed, which means Google Pay won't be having any issues, mic works fine for audio recording via headphones, WhatsApp calls and PUBG, and GPS and Bluetooth will work as they should. If you are still not satisfied with the Pi ROM, or if you want to go back to the stable channel and wait for the official Pi OTA, then follow this procedure, which works regardless of your phone's bootloader being locked or unlocked. So first download these two files, one is the Unbreak tool and the other is OnePlus Qualcomm drivers. Once downloaded, keep these two files in a folder where you can access them easily. Switch off your phone if you can boot your phone. If you have bricked your phone, then press and hold the power button for like 40 seconds to turn off your phone completely. Once the phone is switched off, press and hold the volume up button for like 10 seconds and then connect your phone to your desktop or laptop using the Type-C cable with the volume up button pressed. Now go back to your desktop, search for the Device Manager, or right click on this PC, Manage tab, and here you can find Device Manager tab under Computer Management. Clicking on Device Manager, and here under Ports tab, if you see something like Qualcomm HS-USB QD Loader 9008 with COM port, then everything is fine. But if you are seeing an exclamation mark for this driver, then right click on it, Update driver, browse my computer for driver software, and then through the Browse tab select the folder where you have extracted the OnePlus Qualcomm driver zip contents and hit Next. So that's it, everything is set for the downgrade. Now go back to the folder where you have saved the downloaded files like Unbreak tool and Qualcomm driver, and extract the Unbreak tool contents to your new folder. Here I'm using the Unbreak tool, which reverts back to OxygenOS stable version 5.1.3 based on Oreo 8.1.0. There are also a couple of other versions if you want to try, one based on Nougat for version 4.7.4, and there is also one based on OxygenOS 5.1.5 for 5T. So once you have extracted the Unbreak tool contents, go to that folder and double click this MSM download tool version 4.0. You will get the app screen in about 5 seconds, and now hit the start button and wait until you see the download complete status. The entire process takes about 5 to 6 minutes, so make sure your phone has at least 30% of the battery left. After the restoration is complete, your phone will be automatically rebooted back to the OS. So we are back, let's go to Settings, About Phone. As you can see, we have restored our phone back to OxygenOS version 5.1.3. Now going to System Updates tab, and yes, OTA updates are also working. So to upgrade from 5.1.3 to latest 5.1.7, there are two steps. One is to update your phone to 5.1.4 and then update to 5.1.7. Do note that you cannot directly flash the 5.1.7 ROM because of the treble implementation. You need to first flash the version which was released prior to treble update, and then you can flash any ROM you want. And here in this case, 5.1.4 is the treble preparation update. And in the case of open beta ROMs, I guess open beta 10 for 5T and open beta 12 for OnePlus 5 are the treble preparation updates. You can download the 5.1.4 update via OTA and then update to 5.1.7, or you can download these two ROMs manually, place them in the internal storage of your phone and flash them with the local upgrade option. First I'm flashing the 5.1.4 ROM. As you can see, now the phone is upgraded to 5.1.4. Now flashing the 5.1.7 ROM. Now we are back to the OS after reboot, going to settings, about phone, OxygenOS version is 5.1.7. So that's it, you have completely restored your phone back to stock. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, drop a comment. Goodbye and see you soon.